All right, it is time to begin introducing their bridal party. Beginning with Meredith and Eric. Catherine and Jeff. Emily and Frank. Katie and John. Matron of Honor, Emily and Evan. Matron of Honor, Rebecca, and Best Man, Steve. And last, but not least, it is my honor to introduce to you, Mr. and Mrs. LaCosta.
Pinch myself, you're with me, not someone else. And I'm scared, yeah, I'm still scared. That is all a dream. 'Cause you still look perfect as days go by. Even the worst ones, you make me smile. Stop the world if it gave us time. 'Cause when you love someone, you open up your heart. When you love someone, you make room. If you love someone and you're not afraid to lose them, you probably never loved someone like I do. You probably never loved someone like I do. When you say you love the way I make you feel, everything becomes so real. Don't be scared, no, don't be scared. 'Cause you're all I need. Days go by, even the worst ones, you make me smile. I'd stop the world if it gave us time. 'Cause when you love someone, you open up your heart. When you love someone, you make room. If you never loved someone like I do. You probably never loved someone like I do. All my life, I thought it'd be hard to find the one till I found you. And I find it bittersweet. 'Cause you gave me some to lose. But when you love someone, you open up your heart. When you love someone, you make room. If you love someone,
someone like I do.
All right, how about a hand for the newlyweds?
Hey everyone, my name is Jack. I'm Julie's dad, which makes me the FOB. No, not SOB, FOB, father of the bride. Although I was once reminded that my last name, Boss, spelled backwards, actually makes me a double SOB. But he didn't like me much. I'd also like to introduce or recognize the MOB, if I could. Yes, yes. Most outstanding beauty. And mother of the bride, my lovely wife Beth. She was also the architect of the of this event, so thank you. Under the strict guidance and authority of Julie, of course. But we'll get to that in a minute. We're also thrilled to have, where's John? We're also thrilled to have our son John here and his beautiful wife Katie. They celebrated this, just their marriage, just about 2 years ago now today. They've since moved to beautiful Southern California, so we're probably not going to get them back, but we're glad you're here tonight. Thank you.
Okay.
And where's James? James, thank you. James is a good friend of the family and DJ extraordinaire. Spinning the vinyl tonight. If they still say that, I don't think they still say that, but... Anyway, the rumor has it we might hear from DJ Gavin Boss tonight. Yeah, little cameo. Look, on behalf of Beth and myself, as well as Lisa and Lee, we want to offer up you a big, warm welcome. And we're just so happy and thrilled that each of you could be here to celebrate this special day with Julie and Doug. Lisa and Lee, it's been great getting to know you guys, as well as the rest of the LoCosto family. And I know Julie's just thrilled and excited to now be part of your family. Now, when you look up online, you go to the internet, you say, get some tips, right? I went online and looked for some tips on Father of the Bride speeches. And the very first thing I read, and I verbatim can tell you, it said this. It said, the Father of the Bride speech is meant to be a bit of a warm-up act. Something to be endured rather than enjoyed. So it wasn't too encouraging. So if you just bear down with me for the next 45 minutes or so, together we're going to get through this speech, all right? Let's go. You know, you often hear wedding speeches start by saying, I've been planning this wedding for 29 years or whatever. I mean, and that's sweet, right? That's nice to say. But me, I've only been planning this wedding for about 18 months. Which is about the time Julie brought home this guy named Doug from Pittsburgh. You know, I've since had quite a bit of time to kind of put together the highlight reel, if you will, of the resume on my new son-in-law. And, you know, I had actually had two full pages of notes, Doug, but I couldn't read your handwriting. I tried, but I couldn't read your handwriting. Sorry, so I'll have to try to go from memory. I'm going to try and go from memory, but let me see here. Good looking, intelligent, organized, disciplined, good job. Hey, enough about Julie. No, that was actually Doug. Those were Doug's. Listen, marathon runner, I've actually witnessed that. Scratch golfer, I experienced that. Every time we play golf together and he tries to take my money and... Yesterday he couldn't, so we even had his father engaged to take a little bit of my money yesterday when we played, so, okay. Pittsburgh Steeler fan. Now, having grown up in Pittsburgh myself in the 70s, that was big for me. I think you also wanted me, if I remember the notes, you also wanted me to talk about the night that you and John ran down those teenage kids. True story, John and Doug ran down 4 teenage kids when they decided to dine and dash instead of pay their bill at a local Buffalo Wild Wings. Now, listen, Doug only didn't catch the guy. He brought him back to the restaurant, but he also paid for all 4 of their dinner bills. So that last part is what really impressed me the most, I have to say. Although, not in your notes, by the way, But I've since learned it was the slow, chubby kid that you actually caught. And the other three guys got away, so I think that's a true story now. You know, people ask you when your daughter starts seriously dating somebody, they say, hey, you know, do you like the guy? How is he? And you kind of, depending on the guy, you kind of hem-haw around and say, he's all right, he's a nice guy, okay. But in Doug's case, it's just really refreshing to tell the truth. I mean, he's just simply the kind of guy that you hope your daughter marries. I mean, from the humble yet very confident approach that he took to actually asking for her hand in marriage over a coffee at Eaton Park, which is a pretty classy move these days, right? You know, to the way that he looks at Julie every time he's around her, you know, we knew he was the right guy. So I'm not sure there's a whole lot more to say here. You know, there's not too many guys we turn our only daughter over to, so Doug, welcome to the family. So now on to our lovely daughter and the bride, Julie. I must say, you look absolutely gorgeous tonight in your slightly overpriced wedding gown. Now, I'm going to start by saying that on several occasions over the past 29 years, I probably unintentionally embarrassed you. Well, tonight will be different. You know, some of you might have heard the saying that some of you might have heard the saying. Wait till I get my notes, sorry. Oh yeah, I remember it now. Bad decisions make for really good stories, right? But unfortunately, Julie hasn't given me a lot of stuff to work with over the years, because frankly, she hasn't really made any really bad decisions. And when she did, she seemed to have a plan to fix it, except for our Verizon data plan. And that she never sort of found a way to fix that. So maybe later tonight, the bridesmaids will find some way to tell some stories that maybe your plans didn't work out quite so well. I hope so. You know, 29 years ago, Miss Independence was born. I think the first words out of her mouth, and literally, other than dad-dad, of course, were, I can do it myself. I can do it myself. Those were the first five words, I can do it myself. So I spent most of the early years, frankly, on the other side of a stiff arm. And those words, I can do it myself, you know, in her preteens, morphed into, well, that's just your opinion, right? Five new words, basically the same meaning, right? That's just your opinion, but I can do it myself, right? And then finally, as a senior in high school, she was able to kind of distill and sort of capture everything, her emotions and all of her, into one, literally one word. And it was, seriously? Now, I never knew if that was a statement, I never a question, I just didn't know. I still don't know. If any parents in here know what that is, please let me know. But I did find it quite useful when reviewing the invoices from the wedding. Seriously, and that is a statement, that's not a question. So, we moved on to the college years, and people told me it would get better, and it did. I mean, she moved on to longer conversations and nice conversations, starting with things like, hey guys, really glad you came out to see me this weekend. It was nice, it was really nice. And now as a young adult, you know, my personal favorite, I have to admit, is when I get a phone call that starts with, hi dad, do you have a minute to talk? That's my favorite, so keep that up. Now when Doug and Julie stood together earlier at the ceremony, and Julie, you spoke those really special words, I do, it struck me. It was one of the first times that I can remember that she actually agreed to do anything without challenging it. I mean, she's constantly, right? And Doug, I don't know how you did it, right? I don't know how you did it, she said I do. I mean, I do is just not a thing Julie does. I mean, debate, yeah, right? Delegate, for sure, right? But I do. I mean, I do, at least as a teenager, right? I do was for the rest of the family. Where's John? Right, John? So when we would get home after long vacations, long drives home, we pull up in the driveway, it was time to unload the car, John would sure enough say, "Where did anybody see Julie?" And sure enough, you know, 10 minutes later, she'd emerge from some obscure room in the house, only to kind of tell us, once the car was fully unloaded, basically telling us, you know, what we did wrong or where did we put her purse. You know that's true. Let's see what else. Soccer team, basketball team, swim team, cheerleading team, gymnastics team, and then finally, you know, captain of the Purdue University cheerleading squad. And I should also mention a short stint on the high school golf team. Now, Beth and I, as wise parents, thought it would be a great idea that if Julie could, you know, at the time Title IX was big, and if, you know, you could just play average golf. That's all you had to do was play average golf. You could get one of those scholarships for those unused scholarships, if you will, that went to girls golf scholarships. So, of course, we forced her to do it. Let me just say, strongly encouraged her to join the women's golf team. Now, I have one fond memory of her sitting in the back of the bus, face pressed up against the glass, only one of two girls on the golf team. The golf team bus was pulling away from the high school. She had her bag sort of here and her face pressed up against the glass. And Beth and I were waving to her, and I'm not sure what hand gesture she gave me, but I'm pretty sure she was just scratching her nose. Hey, look now, right? The good thing, right? You guys met a guy that loves to play golf, and now you guys play golf together, so it was in our plan. It was always in our master plan. So tonight, Julie, in closing, I'm going to give you some fatherly advice. And you have no choice but to listen. Are you ready? Okay. Don't change a thing. You're perfect just as you are. We're so proud of the woman you've become. All grown up, mature, independent, exactly how we'd hope you turn out. Continue to put God first in your life, and Doug second. And Doug, no, that's a serious, that's the right. And Doug, you do the same with Julie. Always find some time to call your dad, as he still might have the occasional good piece of advice to give you. And when I'm talking and I'm advising and you're listening and you're thinking, you know, I can do this myself, listen anyway. Doug, today we give you one of the best things we have to give. I'm saying a small farewell to that little girl who couldn't wait to go with me in my borrowed pickup truck and help me landscape the front yard at our first house in Atlanta. We are overwhelmed that the both of you have found the gift of each other to share the rest of your life with. So with that, I'm going to ask that everyone grab their glass and let's raise a toast. Yeah. To Julie and Doug, we wish you every happiness possible and a joyful life together as husband and wife. Cheers.
Good evening, everyone. My name's Steve Cassara. I have the honor of being Doug's best man. And tonight, I'll also be his roast master. I'm just kidding, though, about the roast master part, not being honored to be his best man. If you know Doug or any of our close friends, you know we spend about 90% of our time together roasting one another. And a couple weeks back, a group of us were able to get together for dinner to celebrate Doug, Julie, and this upcoming wedding. And I think that for the most part, we got all the Doug jokes out of our system. I think. There's a few people who couldn't make it that evening. They're here, they're around, you could reach out. Kyle, he's looking up here smiling. He's probably got a few for you. So tonight I really just want to say what a great Doug, our friend Doug has always been. how truly honored I am to be his best man. It was a tough selection process for him. And really, how lucky he is to have found someone like you, Julie. I really think it's great. So Doug and I have known each other for 10 plus years at this point. And in that time, I've come to know Doug as a thoughtful, caring friend. The first person to really kind of offer help anytime you need it. And I'm really, to Doug, I'm sure it's always been really small, something simple to him. But I think it speaks volumes of the person he is and the friendship he has. Is Doug is always the first person, and in my experience, kind of the only person out of all of our friends to ever ask if I've needed help moving. It's strange. He just loves it. Just thoughtlessly lifting heavy objects is kind of his thing. But really, kind of, and he always like jumps really quickly at moving people out of his place too. But I mean, who does that? But that is Doug, right? He's always there to just help you anytime he can. Just don't let him drive the U-Haul. It's nerve-wracking. He gets angry. There's always a few less mirrors. Keep him away from that. But people might not know this as well, but Doug is also very thoughtful, and he's a great listener. He's full of great advice. And any time I've had an issue, Doug's always been there to listen and provide what I'm sure he thinks is thoughtful advice. That advice always involves something about working out, eating protein. I quickly turned to another friend to ask for better advice. But it really is the thought that matters. He's always been there. Doug's been a great friend. He really is to me a special guy. And I'm so glad he's found someone like you, Julie. I just want to mention a few moments when I came to the realization you two were a perfect couple. The first, and there's been a few jokes already, but when we found out she loves Costco. I found out earlier today the rings were from there. It's probably the first weekend they won't make it there. Unless they might go tomorrow, who knows. Second, when Doug said Julie could give him a run for his money in golf. And third, and my favorite, when we found out that not only did Julie buy Doug Rick Ross tickets for his birthday, and I think you guys might be putting a Rick Ross song on later for us tonight, but she subjected herself to the entire concert, meaning I didn't have to go to a Rick Ross concert with Doug anymore. Doug, Julie, you guys are a beautiful couple. I'm so happy for you. And just thank you for letting me be a part of this day. I think it's been really beautiful. And everyone, let's once again, please raise a glass to them. And cheers, guys. I love you both. Thank you.
What an amazing day so far. Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Boss, for putting on such an amazing evening. And for all who came out to celebrate with Julie and Doug tonight. My name is Rebecca Huber.
And I'm Emily Putman. We're Julie's best friends from college, and we are so honored to stand by her side as her matrons of honor today.
Now, we've known Julie for 11 years now, so we thought of 11 things that we love and appreciate about Julie. Now, before you get nervous for a long, lengthy, emotional, pregnant ladies toast, please know we've cut it down to five. Five things, even though, Julie, there are countless things we love and appreciate about you.
The first thing we love about Julie is her composure. As student athletes at Purdue,
boiler up!
Julie and I shared a locker room freshman year. I remember waving to Julie on my way to practice and thinking she seemed like such a nice girl. Little did I know she would become one of my lifelong best friends. We both went on to study economics and spent many long days and nights in the basement of Potter Library. Even with the stress of preparing for exams and managing busy schedules, Julie had a way of making things fun and maintaining a sense of balance. For example, sometimes you need to do a quick lap through Harry's chocolate shop in the middle of a Saturday night study session. I always admired Julie's composure and courageous spirit towards everything she does, whether it be school, cheerleading, or in more recent years, her successful career in the agricultural industry.
All right, the second thing we love about Julie is her matchmaking abilities. And I know Katie and John are appreciative of that. But they are not the only ones. Julie brings people together and is constantly making meaningful connections with others. Now, Julie, your track record's not 100%. I've had a few dates gone wrong in the past to prove it. But you've taught me that the world is a much bigger and better place when we step outside our comfort zones and make new friends.
The third thing we love about Julie is that she's a boss.
She's got a great sense of humor.
She can pull off any style, including hats.
She can still throw a back tuck and stick the landing.
She travels all over the country as she continues to climb the corporate ladder.
She likes butter on her bagel.
She has a very convincing Australian accent.
And she can drop the middle splits and win any dance off.
See it later. Her new last name may be Lacoste, but she'll always be a boss.
All right, the fourth thing we love about Julie is that she always seeks the truth. Julie has a passion for knowing and growing deeper with Christ. One of the main reasons we became friends our freshman year at cheer practice, boiler up, was because we both needed someone to go to church with. Now, it may have seemed surprising that Julie and I remained such close friends after we graduated and moved to completely different cities. But we've always remained closer than ever because at our core, we have the same purpose. Julie, I know that no matter where life may take us, you will always be a forever friend. Oh boy. I can always count on you to be a positive light in my life and speak the truth. And it's so encouraging that you and Doug have the same foundation. Your passion for truth and righteousness has always encouraged me in my own walk of faith, and I know that many other people in this room can say the very same thing.
The fifth thing we love about Julie is her loving nature. Julie cares deeply for her family and friends, and she makes that clear in her day-to-day life. It's especially obvious how much she cares about Doug and the life they have started together today. From the moment we heard about Doug, we knew something special was forming. You could hear the excitement and certainty in Julie's voice when she talked about him. It was clear that he was the one. Since then, they have built such a strong foundation that has led them to this day and to the start of the rest of their lives.
And Doug, we are so glad you found someone as loving as Julie to spend the rest of your life with. When Julie is with you, it's obvious that she's so happy and herself. Coming from the other two-thirds of the trifecta, we're ecstatic that you're joining the family. And we can't wait to see what God has in store for your future.
And Julie, we love you so much and are so grateful for your friendship. We couldn't be happier for you and Doug as we celebrate your love today. So please, raise a glass to the new
Mr. and Mrs. Lacoste!
I have the privilege to know Julie and Doug from the Block Church. They've been attending for a couple years, and I just want to say a special congratulations to both of you. So proud of you both and excited to celebrate here tonight. And I'm honored to say grace over our food before we eat. So if you don't mind, to close your eyes and bow your head. Jesus, thank you so much that you've already been present through the whole day. And we just pray a blessing over the food and just conversations and time, and a special blessing over Julie and Doug as they begin their marriage here in this community represented in this room. In Jesus' name, amen. You made me see for all the joy you brought to my life, for all the wrong that you made right, for every dream you made come true, for all the love I found in you. I'll be forever thankful, baby. You're the one who held me up, never let me fall. You're the one who saw me through it all.
You were my strength when I was weak. You were my voice when I couldn't speak. You were my eyes when I couldn't see. You saw the best there was in me. Lifted me up when I couldn't reach. You gave me faith 'cause you believed.
Alrighty, big round of applause right now for Father-Daughter Dance. Jack and Julie look amazing.
Can I have this dance with you one more time before I start down the road of my brand new life? There's no way to thank you for all that you have done. No matter how old I get, I will always be your son. We're riding trikes in my dirt bikes and crashing in the sand. I probably scared you half to death. Hey mom, look, no hands. You were my best friend, you were my number one fan. Oh, every time that I got hurt, you were there to hold my hand. Oh, I may not call you as much as I should. I may not say I love you as much as I could. But you got to know, well, this one thing is true. The person I've become and all I am, I owe it all to you. Wild, I was free. I made every mistake you could make, but you still believed in me. Looking back, I was a rat when I thought I knew it all. But every time that I fell short, well, you were there to catch my fall. You taught me how to give and how to be a man. Well, there was love in all you did, and now I understand. When you're far away from me, we'll just play this song out loud. And when you think of me, well, I hope I made you proud. I may not call you as much as I should. I may not say I love you as much as I could, but you've got to know, well, this one thing is true. The person I've become and all I am. My life, my wife, my family, and my friends, I owe it all to you.
Give Doug and his mom a big round of applause for the mother-son dance right now. Here we go.
This hit that ice cold. Michelle fight for that white gold. This
one
for them hood girls, them good girls, straight masterpieces. Styling, wilding, living it up in the city. Got Chuck's on with Saint Laurent. Got
hallelujah. Girl, set your hallelujah. Girl, set your hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch.
Let's go.
Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Hey, 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 oh.
Stop. Wait a minute. Fill
my cup. Hey, I have a quick favor real quick. Can everyone take 3 steps forward right now? 3 steps forward. Come on. Here we go. Let's party. Come on.
Jackson, Mississippi.
Here we go.
If we show up, we gon' show up.
Hands up. Break it down. Come on. I need you guys to make a round of applause if you're having a good time right now. Here we go. I need you to sing it with me. Uptown, funk it up. Uptown, funk it up. See it.
Uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up.
Louder. Uptown, funk you up. Uptown, funk you up. Now see it.
Uptown, funk you up.
Now let's see it. Break it down. Here we go.